All right, this is gonna be episode 2 of Over the Ridgeline. Okay, on the road again. It is like 7:30 in the morning. We're leaving Grand Prairie and headed to Alaska. Let's get day 3 rocking and rolling. Should be getting to a lot better, better views today. Woke up to a whopping 23 degrees today. That's fantastic. I'm used to waking up to 60 or 70, so it was pretty chilly, but totally worth it. Well, it's a good thing I stopped, I think, last night instead of going to Dawson Creek. So this is the road conditions out there. I'm glad I pulled over, because last night traveling at midnight would have not been good, you know? Frost heaves. Yeah. Good thing they put signs out. Alright, just got to Dawson Creek. We are gonna fill up, check fluids, do all that jazz before we hit the official Alaska highway. Excited to finally get to this point because it's a good mile marker, and about halfway. So I think it'll be good. I think we'll be able to get the things done that we need to fairly quickly, and it's about 9 o'clock in the morning. So I think it'll be a good day, and I hope the roads stay relatively clear. Yeah. So my wiper fluid wasn't coming out, so it's frozen. Something I did not remember to do was get some wiper fluid that was sub-zero or freezing. But that's okay. We'll just have to make do, I suppose. I will also say this. If you're gonna make this trip, make sure you have at least half tread on your tires. It is a pretty rough road, especially moving forward. But the last probably 10 miles or so was pretty rough. But you want to make sure that that's one thing you don't have to worry about is the tires, because it's probably the last thing you want to do on the side of the road when it's freezing outside, right? Just make sure you got good tread on your tires, all your fluids are good, and yeah, you'll be set. All right, so I got some wiper fluid for negative 45 degrees. Hopefully that kind of thaws out what's in there right now, as well as maybe the temperature of the motor for a while, and hopefully get it working at least a little bit.
My favorite parts of the trip is just coming over a hill like this, but this one specifically, this one's a really big one. It's like the Grand Canyon for Canada. But it's big, it's epic, it looks cool. The bridge is actually really cool that you get to. I love coming over and seeing views like this. They're just amazing. I don't think the camera does it justice by any means. Stop and get some pictures. I don't think this will capture just how beautiful this is. This is literally my favorite place. So much, but I love it. It's just such a great view. The river's beautiful. Hope you guys can see it. Such a great view. Winter tires only. We'll have to see how these ridge grapplers do. All right, I stopped in Fort St. John to get gas, just to top off on the way to Fort Nelson. I'll tell you, on these trips like this, you will never go wrong to keep your tank full. So just keep that in mind as you take on the Alcan when you do.
Check that out, man. That view is amazing.
It is so beautiful in this area between Fort St. John and Fort Nelson. So vast, so big. You feel like this little tiny speck on earth, and it is just vast forest. Man, this is beautiful. Really take your time and enjoy this drive. I've been sleeping at night, just driving during the day, and man, it is just amazing. Definitely something you need to do in your lifetime if you're wanting to experience greatness. Like, just, man, it is so beautiful. There's no words to describe it. I hope you take the time, make the drive, save up for it. You know, whether you do an RV, whether you just do a car, you know, whatever it is, just go and enjoy the scenery. Also, while traveling, expect random construction sites.
Beautiful out, absolutely beautiful out. Just here at the construction site, stop. It says wait up to 15 minutes for the pilot car, so second in line and we're just chilling. But yeah, I gotta pay attention to stuff. So I'm gonna try to get to Watson Lake. I'm hoping the roads are just as good, because if they are, then I'll be able to make it there tonight and maybe even a little bit further, but make it there by dinner for sure. But I just did my fuel mileage and getting 18 miles a gallon. I'm impressed. I was going about 65, 70 for most of it. There are some parts I was going about 60, but for the most part, it's about 65, 70 and gained like 2 to 3 miles per gallon. So, hey, would you know, for a Ridgeline with 33s and stuff like that, for me, that I'm impressed. I'm excited about that. That definitely is saving a lot of money that I was expecting on spending. So, yeah. Wow, I just totally hit a mud puddle. That was amazing. All right, guys, let's get after it. Oh, man. So this sign says, slushy conditions, expect delays, and bison on the road. So, we'll see what it brings. Let's do this. I don't know if you'll grasp it on the camera, but that is amazing. It has so much open country, it's insane. I already know this will not do it justice, but this is such an epic view. Mountain ranges go forever. Roads are getting a little sketchy. We'll have to slow down a bit, but okay, well, here up at the summit, it's roads are getting a little sketchy, so I'll probably be slowing down a little bit. Nonetheless, beautiful up here. Oh, I love it. So hopefully my wiper fluid can thaw out with the engine and temperatures outside. Hopefully it'll thaw so I can start using it and kind of get that other fluid through it.
Got some caribou in the road. Let's do this.
Love driving down passes that rivers at the bottom like this. Makes you feel so secluded. Look how magnificent that looks. Like, that is just huge, straight up. That is amazing.
Man, something I will say and admit to is I love driving mountain roads. I love the banks, and it just makes you feel like a race car, right? But that is something that's really nice about this road too, is that
It has a lot of banks, it has a lot of mountain roads. And if you don't like going fast and like doing that, great, great scenery. So, you know, I hope you've enjoyed the view so far and the content. Stay tuned for more coming.
Maybe it's COVID, but it's like a ghost town in there now, unfortunately. But yeah, just gotta clean the windshield, fill up, and head out. But used to have tons of trinkets and things in there. Thought it was tons of fun. But definitely recommend coming here on your travels. Food's really good too, by the way. So enjoy, have fun. Hopefully, see you on the road. Okay, so I just talked to the person at the cashier, and they said that they just moved to the building behind. So, right there. They were right there only, but now they're there. So that's great. Good for them. Glad it's still rocking and rolling. Enjoy. Let's get back on the road. Buddy, not taking a picture.
Should be. Just thought it was cool, okay?
Starting to accelerate just a little bit. Hopefully it doesn't get worse as time goes. We'll see. It's only gotten a little bit worse, so I slowed down a little bit. see. But overall, good. Only about 50 miles away from Watson Lake. Gonna get there, see how things are, see what the conditions are, and go from there.
All right, roads are getting a little bit more dicey here. I know they're not too slick, but since the snow is sticking, you know, that's it's not the best sign. So I'm gonna try to get to Watson quick and smooth, and go from there. All right, I think I've officially became a lower 48 in person. yeah, that snowstorm actually was kind of intense. It was like 15 miles, and it was snowing, blizzarding, if that's a word. And so I was going 45, 50, but it's definitely, it was nerve-wracking for sure. I haven't driven in snow in 2.5 years, so yeah, that was pretty interesting, I'm not gonna lie. But truck handled great. No complaints on the Ridgeline or the tires. No, they did great, at least in that storm there. So yeah, it was good.
Yep, gotta apparently stop here to do a COVID check. Did not know this. Thought it was in Beaver Creek. Hopefully everything goes well.
Okay, so I gotta fill out all of this, check transiting through, and then try to remember every stop I made to fill up since I entered Canada. Well, this is gonna be interesting. Well, oh, there's a gas station right there. Looks pretty hairy up there, that's for sure. Welcome to Watson Lake. And then we got like, we're in like the eye of the storm. Crap going on over there and behind us now. Whew. Just gotta get some gas and get out of here. 24 hours to get out of the country. Luckily, Beaver Creek or the border is only about 10 hours away. Nonetheless, that's all we have. Good times. Ah, good old snow machines.
Well, I am now at Watson Lake and have 24 hours to get out of the country. I'm liking the performance thus far of the Ridgeline. It's doing really, really good. It's performed very well given conditions and never testing them in these conditions before. Looks good, feels good. Performing well, everything's doing great. Signpost Forest, this is legit.
Warmer weather, I would totally stop and check all this out.
If I wasn't on a time crunch, but let's do this.
Looks like a pretty crazy storm. I think it's rain though. So vast, so much space out here. Nothing but forest.
Well, it looks like it's gonna start storming again. So hopefully I can get through the storm before it's dark. That's the goal. But take as much time as needed to get through safely. Drive with roads like this, but it's all right. Progress is the point, right? Progression is all that matters.
Okay, in the city, or the village, excuse me, the village of Telslin. It's 10:30, I'm gonna crash here for the night and then get going tomorrow. Yeah, good times. Truck is looking nice and dirty. I love that. I don't know why,
but I just like it when it's dirty.
Yep.
Good times.
Well, hopefully enjoy the day. That's day 3, I believe. Starting to lose track.